Hi folks, so welcome back to the Astroform channel and thanks for tuning in. Today I wanted to make a quick video on how to set up plate solving in Sequence Generator Pro. Now, if you do not know what Sequence Generator Pro is, please check out my earlier introduction video on that by clicking on the top right information icon of the screen. And you will go to the video where I explain what Sequence Generator Pro is and what it can do for you. Also, if you like this content, please consider subscribing to my channel. So, right, let's get into it, guys. So, what is plate solving? Well, when you go to Tools and you go to Framing and Mosaic Wizard, you will get to this particular screen. And actually, we will go through the first step now, and I will discuss the next steps later on. So, in the first step, Sequence Generator Pro asks you to define an area of the sky and click on Fetch. And you can do this in different ways. So, first of all, you can type in the astronomical object that you are interested in by, for instance, using Messier numbers or New General Catalog numbers or IC numbers of that particular deep sky object. But what you can also do is maybe you have an image of an earlier imaging session of a particular object and you want to frame, you want to take pictures that are exactly the same as your last session. You can then also click on Browse and upload this image. And finally, you can define an object by the right ascension and declination coordinates. So you can enter the right ascension and declination coordinates in these two boxes. And then Sequence Generator Pro will fetch that particular object from its database. So without further ado, let's get into it. So let's take M45, so the famous Pleiades Messier object number 45, and we can click on Fetch, and then Sequence Generator Pro will automatically generate a picture of that deep sky object for you. So that is already nice. And now the really interesting part is when I click on this image, and I will put this to one by one. It will show me how the camera will be positioned when I want when taking images of that astronomical object. So here you can exactly define with pinpoint accuracy the way you want your framing to be when you are going to image a particular deep sky object. So I want to center this, or you would like to center this in the Pleiades, in the center of your image, of course. And okay, without going through all of the next steps now, you can ask Sequence Generator Pro to create this particular target in a sequence for you. And it does that. And then, as you can see here, I did it a couple of times before. But you see that M45 now is added as an astronomical object to your sequencer, to your sequence list. And you, by clicking on settings, you can see that it automatically generated the coordinates of this deep sky object from its database. So that's really nice. And when you run the sequence, actually, it will slew automatically to this Messier object, so the Pleiades, and it will automatically center the object you are interested in imaging with a pinpoint accuracy. So that is really nice. I will go through three specific steps. First, what you have to do is download the correct software you need to set up plate solving in Sequence Generator Pro. The next step is you have to add the correct settings in Sequence Generator Pro, and with that I mean you have to enter correct settings in the Equipment Profile Manager. We will get into that. And as a third step, you want to use this framing and mosaic wizard to add a target, like I showed you just before, to your sequence list. And then you can run the sequence. So I hope you find this video interesting, and let's get into the first step, which is downloading the correct software that you need in order to set up plate solving in Sequence Generator Pro. You want to go to this website, planewave.com/forward files/forward catalogs. And you want to download two particular files in that directory, being setupapmcatalog.exe and ucacc3ps.zip. When you downloaded the setup file to your laptop or desktop, you also want to click on that file in order to install the software, the APM software you need. And also, after downloading the zip file, you want to unzip this file to a specific directory so that you can refer to that directory in Sequence Generator Pro. And finally, and most probably, you already have this, you can go to scom-standards.org/forward-downloads/forward-scope-drivers.htm in order for you to download the correct SCOM driver you need for your telescope mount. And of course, this would depend on the brand of your mount you have. I have a Celestron mount, so I can download here the Celestron software, so it installs a driver for all computerized Celestron telescopes. But maybe you will you have a SkyWatcher driver, for instance, and you then want to download the SkyWatcher SynScan mount controller by clicking on download here. And also, yeah, after download, it is an execute file, so you have to you click on that exe file and install the software on your computer. So the next step will be to add the correct information to Sequence Generator Pro. So let's get into that right now. You might want to go to Tools and Equipment Profile Manager. And here you have to select the profile you are going to use for your imaging sessions. If you're not sure how to set up an Equipment Profile Manager, please click on the video that is appearing right now on the top right of your screen, the information button on the top right of your screen, in which I explain how to set up your camera and your filter wheel as a particular profile in Sequence Generator Pro. But for now, I will go to plate solving. And, well, I'm not an expert on this, so I will just show you the settings I have used. So, as an interface setting, I am using PlateSolve number 2, which appears to work just fine for me. What is really, really important is that you click on settings here. And this will bring you to this particular screen. And in this particular screen, you want to click on File and Configure Catalog Directories. Okay, and when you go to this catalog directory here, you can see that you have to select the directory in which you have downloaded the automatic plate match software. So I just showed you in the first step to download the APM exe file and to run that exe file on your laptop or desktop. And this is actually the default folder in which it will install. So program file, Starry Ridge APM. And you want to select that particular directory so that Sequence Generator Pro knows that the automatic plate match software is in that that particular directory and will use that directory for plate solving. Also the UCAC3, so that was the zip file that you downloaded and unzipped on your laptop or desktop. You have to select here the directory to which you have unzipped that particular file. And it will return to you status OK and status OK once it has actually found the correct files. And for the other parts, I left all of these settings to default. If you look at, for instance, parameters, there are a lot of settings. But yeah, I will just put it here and wait for 10 seconds. And so you can just go through all of them and make sure you have a similar setup for your particular Sequence Generator Pro. But wait, the only thing I did was to add my location coordinates. So 52 degrees latitude and 5 degrees longitude. That is actually the location in the Netherlands where I am imaging from. So you might want to set that up for your own location, depending on where you live on Earth and where you are imaging. Okay, if you have performed this part, then you can go on and look at these selection options. For search, I have put this to the max number of regions. For binning, I'm using 2x2. And I have set the exposure time to 10 seconds, meaning that Sequence Generator Pro will take pictures of 10 seconds when trying to plate solve your image. The attempt to center, I have always put this at 4x. So it will try to center the object four times. Here you can also play around with the allowance for error. So I have put this to 500 pixels. So when the error of centering is less than 500 pixels, it will consider that centering as accurate and start taking images of your deep sky object. And here you have a rotator error. I am actually not using any kind of automated rotation right now, but you can see here when you have an automated rotator, you can say, okay, there is maybe a little bit of error that I allow. Here it's set to 3 degrees. And then it also you can define the filter through which it will take this 10 second exposure. So you can say you want to use the luminance filter for that. In my case, it depends on whether or not you have a filter wheel, of course. And use blind solve failover. I never checked this on. I really don't know what this is. Okay, it's set to astrometry.net. So with that, everything you need to set up is set up, except for one thing, and that is your camera. And I already explained in another video how to set up your camera and filter wheel, so please go to that video by clicking on the information button on the top right of your screen. But just to get to this part, settings and specs for plate solving, it's really important to have the scale and also the pixels set up in a correct way. So yeah, the scaling can be calculated. Actually, I have a spreadsheet for this, and I will include that in the comment section down below. You have to check your pixel size of the camera, which is based on an setting. So for me, the 1600mm Pro is 3.8, and you have to know the focal length of the telescope you are imaging through. In my case, this is 560mm, and then you can actually calculate the inch per pixel that you have to put into Sequence Generator Pro. So in my case, the pixel setting or the scale setting is 1,40, and it uses actually this formula. So you have your pixel size of the sensor of your camera, you have to multiply that by 206,3, and then you will divide that number by the focal length of your telescope. But yeah, if you're not sure, you can just use my spreadsheet. And for instance, you have a pixel size of 5 and a focal length of 800. It will give you an inch per pixel here of 1,29. So if you have you have this information, the correct scale you are using, you want to put that value into this particular box, the scale box. And also pixels, yeah, you just have to know the resolution of your camera in pixels. So in my case, this is 4656 pixel width by 3520 pixel height for the ZWO1600 Mono Pro camera. Okay, so these are all of the settings that you need to set up before before you are actually able to use the framing mosaic wizard to add a target to your sequence. Let's move on to the final part of this video by clicking on tools, and we go back to framing and mosaic wizard. We have seen this screen before, but let's get into a little bit more detail. We can first click on the tab that says profile on the top, and you can see here that I have basically selected my profile, my default profile, which is ZWO1600 Mono Pro. This is the Mono Pro camera we have just set up using the Equipment Profile Manager. But it's important to note that depending on the equipment you're going to use, you can also select a different profile. So for in my case, I also have a color camera, the ZWO178. And I have a Canon D1200 EOS camera. And I also created profiles for those cameras. So you can here select the camera and the equipment you are going to use for that particular imaging session. As shown you before, you can select an object. And just to show you that it also takes a new global catalog numbers, we will select the new global catalog 7000. Which is, of course, the California Nebula, the Cygnus Wall, and also the greater region, a really nice hydrogen region in the constellation Cygnus. What I didn't show you is that you can also play around with the field of view. So if we have a narrower field of view and we fetch a field of view of 1 degree, we will get a zoomed in view of that area. And so you can play around with the image here. So let's leave it at 3 degrees for now, which gives us this nice and big overview of the Cygnus region. And let's go on to step number two, which is define the camera data. And actually, when you have set up your profile in Sequence Generator Pro, it automatically fills out this information for you. So in my case, we have a scale of 1,40 for my ZWO1600 Mono Pro and a resolution of 4656 pixel width by 3520 pixel height. If I change my equipment, for instance, I'm changing to my color camera, the scale and the resolution will change accordingly. So that is really nice to have. You can even adjust this manually when you did not set up any profile. So the third step, it says define the target. And this is just like we did before. We can draw a target rectangle. So I'm just clicking on my mouse and I can drag this rectangle over the picture. Let's here select one by one to start off with. And here, this is really important because this rectangle, it represents the exact resolution of your camera. So when you start imaging, you will get this particular resolution. And if you click off the entire field, it will really show you the image you will get once you will start your imaging session. So this is really nice to have. You can also do composite tiles. We only have one composite tile selected right now. But you can check this on and off. And also you can use this slider to rotate the image. When you have a rotator, it will automatically rotate your camera to the position of your liking. I don't have a rotator in my equipment, so I have to manually go outside and then turn my camera a little bit around until I am happy with the field of view I am getting. Let's go to step number four, because here, without going in too much detail, I want to show you that you can create a mosaic. And what is a mosaic? Well, you already saw it a little bit. Let's check on the composite tiles box here. Here you can see that although my camera is limited to a resolution of 4656 by 3520, you can say to Sequence Generator Pro to create multiple targets. So you can say, okay, I want this whole area to be imaged. And Sequence Generator Pro suggests that we would need 4 images for that in order to collect all of this, this whole area. And here you can also play around with the overlap. So now I'm coming to the overlap. You can choose to have an overlap between the pictures of 20% or maybe 0% if you are really confident that you have pinpoint accuracy. So, okay, this is the final part of the framing and mosaic wizard. And then all that is left is to click on this button to create an image in your sequencer. And here you can, replace the targets in the sequence. When you have an old sequence and you want to replace it by a new sequence, you can click on that. And here, if you have already a sequence that is running, you can append targets to sequence. It means that it will add these 4 targets to your particular sequence. And then here, auto-rotate or validate rotation on mosaic start. You can check that on or off. I usually check this off right now because I do not have any automatic rotation right now. And usually I'm not making mosaics at the moment, but I can imagine when you are creating a mosaic, you want this rotation to be exactly the way you want it to be. So then you want to check this on actually. And then slew to target and then center. I have selected, this is the default selection, precision, centering with plate solve. This is also the thing we have set up in this video, so we can check this on. Then there are some other options, which I never use actually, and they are maybe more imprecise as it is suggested here. So we click on OK, and then it will create 4 new targets and it will add them to the sequence you already have. So you can here, you see here that that's the Sequence Generator Pro. It has created 4 specific targets now. So target number 1, target number 2, and target number 3, and target number 4. And they represent the tiles 1, 2, 3, 4, as selected in your framing and mosaic wizard. So just to be sure, let's go to this setup of tile number 1. You can see here that the RA and DEC, they are, for instance, the RA is 0 and 46 seconds. When we move on to the second target, the RA is at 06.03 seconds. So you can see that you are now able to create a mosaic. And of course, now we can move on and define for each of the targets the specific images we want to take. If you're interested in how to define your sequencer, I have to refer you to another video, because this video is already getting a little bit long. Please check out the video that I have made on setting up the camera and filter wheel. I will leave a link on the top right of the screen right now, and I will also leave a link in the comment section so that you can look at how to set up your sequencer in Sequence Generator Pro. And with that, we are at the end of the video. If you like this content, please consider subscribing to my channel. I really would appreciate that. And thanks for watching, and see you later. Bye-bye.